respect to Professor Mahendra Bhai, I will take now 2 minutes of my session and try to point out first, since it is connected very interestingly, what Professor Nadkarni has pointed out about the issue of whether calligraphy is required to design typeface. Well, I am generally considered as a practicing type calligrapher for last 20 years, which is not really correct. I'm an experimental calligrapher. And I will definitely try to give my opinion about this because I see a lot of Indian students sitting here in the auditorium. And it's absolutely new generation who are going to be responsible to design typefaces tomorrow. We look forward that they will design text typefaces in Indian situation. Calligraphy is unavoidably important to understand Indian structure of letters. Calligraphy differs with the Western letter forms like Latin and Roman. In Indian situation, it differs. It cannot be just called as ligatures. There are four-way joineries. A lot of understanding is required. And in this scenario, calligraphy works as a tool. It doesn't work as a craft. It works as a tool to have internalization of the letter form and then make a decision. We look forward for the better future than the broken letters. We look forward for new congen consonant combinations from the new generations. And those kinds of situations cannot be handled unless you know script thoroughly well, unless you know calligraphy very well. I'm not referring to the expressive calligraphy. I'm referring to the most disciplined calligraphy, which if you study history of Western world, they have rigorously gone through. And then they have came to this situation. So even from that point of view, we really have to, and it's not a struggle. It's an enjoyable journey. You just have to give yourself to that. Yeah. So calligraphy is important as far as type design, specifically the text type design is concerned. That's just my opinion. Some people will agree, some people will disagree. Let's see how it comes to, because it took a long time, at least a year for me, to forget that I'm a calligrapher when I was approaching to the subject like handwriting or the script. While investigating handwriting with the kids, 1.5 years took long time for me to forget as a calligrapher. It was easier for me to forget that I'm a type designer, but it was really a difficult task even today to forget myself that I'm a calligrapher. Let's see how those backgrounds create some kind of a pointers to look at the situation of writing of our kids through these books. Child learning letter form. Making a letter is a process, ultimately produces a letter. I will not read what I have written here. I expect that you can read and that will be simple journey. It's a multi-sensory phenomena. It's a long journey. It takes time for a small kid to first recognize a letter form. He takes long time to recognize something form, that form as a letter form. And then once that is internalized very well, where most of the types which are outside he see are influential in that. Writing activity starts really much later in the life. It starts maybe at the age of 6 or something. Before that, and when it starts, there are traditional and modern methods of learning and teaching. Self-learning is obviously going on from years and even today. Something which is controlled learning or can be taught, called as instructional learning, in that category, we have teaching aids which are instructional in nature. I think we can only talk about those teaching aids rather than the outside reality which is uncontrollable. In this area, there is a list which is made like dust slates from traditionally the way Indians used to learn on the dust slate. Then there are a lot of ways to other like stone slate and chalks, and all that material was used when the printing was introduced and when the literacy was too much in demand to the country, which is very important. Literacy for everyone must, and that has given birth to the books, which are called primers. Primers basically are found by and large of two types. One is for observation and one is to learn how to write. The first one, in that there are many categories again, like there are charts, there are cards which you can show and just give a visual input. So for a first formation year, just the visual input of a letter form was going on for a long time. Even the phonetic association to a letter which is taught to the child by just showing the letter. He don't have been insisted to draw the letter for a long time. Therefore, the responsibility of these visual charts and visual books becomes very, very important. Because what is the first exposure and what is the first dent on the mind is considered as an idol by that human being, whether it is idol or whether it is not idol. It is considered as an idealistic letter form. And that also influenced later on onto his writing and onto his manner of writing. We have categorized very meticulously all these things. Let's forget, this is a chart which shows more specific categorization of those manuals and the age groups and whether they are handled by parental guidance or they are self-learning. Only we are focusing this particular talk on the books which are meant for observation and the manuals which are meant for writing or practicing writing. How we learn to actually letter is while seeing it, it's by constant clear repetition of a phonetic sound and constant clear repetition of a symbol or a sign which is shown to the child, he understands the association. So that constant repetition we also see in the manuals where kids actually practice. There are about 72 books and all, and we are still collecting many, many books. I have very few as a case study here with a specific reason. So there are O and O1 type of books and there are W1 and W2 and W3. These numbers are actually different categories. Like there are certain books only teach numbers, there are certain books only teach letters. So they are very minutely categorized. Let's look at the O type of books, which are meant for observation. Why we have considered this particular publication? Because this is a responsible publication which creates books in all Indian languages. There are very few publications create books in all languages. And therefore, we see a similarity in all the layouts and everything. Although the books, these colors and pictures are very attractive, please, let's keep it in mind, we are just talking about the letter form and nothing else. This is Gujarati, Bengali, Tamil, Telugu, Urdu. Let's look at inside what happens. Now, the earlier chunk of books cover which you have seen is actually by one publisher which distributed entire India and for different states. But let's focus on only Bombay, or maybe with the limitations of my own research, let's limit only to the Bombay books and which are available in the same city. And I have collected those, separated them and tried to analyze them. I found the most cheapest book, which is range starting from 5 rupees to 40 rupees, these books are available. One which you are seeing is by Mahesh Publication, which is a 5 rupees book found in a train. I got really scared because this goes to masses in true sense. Look at the letter forms. Most of you are typography students, so you are already started understanding what I'm trying to show here. Just look at the letter forms. Such 5 books we took it for visual analysis and 5 letters from them. Why these 5 letters we selected? You can see immediately can come out. There are few of the right hand vertical bar, middle vertical bar, short vertical bar, and a little complicated or odd kind of a letter which is shown. All these 5 letters are separated from these 5 books which are available in Bombay and which are constantly trying to give some kind of an impression about how letter E or the or RU looks like. I think most of the variations are clearly visible. At least one can, on a very surface level, can say there is, I don't know, every book has given a thought about what color should be given to the letter, from there to what structure of the letter should be. Some of these books, if you see carefully, we'll see this slide a little carefully, they are using ready-made typefaces to show the first exposure of a letter form. Now, these typefaces are basically meant to type a text, means a word. And we are showing a single letter out of that typefaces. So there are a lot of issues with this. When you see these letters single, they are imbalanced because they are not meant to be viewed single. They are meant to be viewed in the composition of word. They will never come as a single letter. But because of the convenience and the availability, these are used. Also, there are these books, some book is showing it in a reverse. And if you see the comparison of Ru or the tail, someone will say, what child will understand exactly what I'm trying to say? When that mind don't understand anything, don't we think that it's our responsibility to give a very clear picture of the letter which he is going to see? These are much more deeper variations from those books. Look what happened to the letter Kh, right hand side top line and the left hand side top line of even the top authentic looking Kh is literally going to fall down somewhere, either to the right or to the left when it is shown single. And the second one, I don't think any grammar exists of typography there. The angles everywhere is changing. Just somebody has tried to get the weightage. Some of these letters were lettering. They are not even the typefaces. They are alterations to the letter forms. And still, they are not meant like single, because that person who is doing the lettering is, I will not call it educated, but is really not giving a serious thought that it is going to a child and for the first exposure. Then let's go into little bit. These are basic issues. These are not deeper issues, according to me. If you look at letter Ch, has really stunned me that 63rd Republican Day we celebrated, I seriously took 400 typefaces and segregated letter Ch, because the types are going to be responsible finally, that somebody is going to print those books for kids. And look at all those 400 whatever typefaces from one company or any company, you also can take it and see letter Ch, you will find a lot of variations in a core structure. Can you see the small dots where the variations of a simple structure and the joinery is very clear? There are about 2-3 possibilities you see of letter Ch in all this. I have tried to ask expert, and experts gives me answer that even in manuscripts you find, in some manuscripts you find the joineries are different, in some is different. This is a time that although we study our manuscripts, but we also have to make some decision which is of today. And because yesterday it was, writing activity was not that generalized, or the country was not in a requirement of so much of a literacy either. So it is today's question, that do we have to really formalize it or scientifically finalize it, their decisions about every letter. Look at the top line breakage. These are similar looking. Ch and some part of a Dh looks like. If you are a little bit well versed with Devanagari, you can understand. Same situation then happens in the writing primers. It looks like people are really not confident about this letter. the model character and the written mannerism absolutely have a contradictions. If you see here, the pen lift, that we'll see later in the next chapter, but right now at least letter for observation we are on now. The breaking, the tracing practice manuals. Now we are trying to analyze the tracing practice manuals, which are used generally at the age of 6, where the kids generally draw the letter form again and again and they trace it. Every manual has a different squares, different amount of squares. Like the range goes from 4 times one has to render letter to some other manual says 104 times. So there is a big range. There is no number set yet. These are few examples of those separated. Some book says only render once and it's on. It can be done. And these are also found in the same city, not in a different state. Here the model letter and written letter differs, absolutely. I call it unreasonable pen lift. The pen lift which is required for the calligraphy and the pen lift which is required for the written differs a lot. That's why we feel either these charts are underestimating a child or overestimating. Look at letter R. Is absolutely calligrapher's delight to design the written letter form, which is very illogical. For the calligraphic cut pen it's fine, but with, and we have testified on the kids, they really get confused how the knot should be. Eventually they learn. Somebody told me eventually anyway they learn, but that's, we are talking about the ability of a human being and not the design product. Look at the and visarga dot shown in a linear fashion. Very disturbing. If we'll keep it as it is, what is happening with the new media in America on the website? People are taking it as it is, as if it's coming from India, it's authentic, and that is what is happening. These issues are so subtle in nature, and that makes us, when we grow up, ask these questions, that why we need conjunct consonants, why we need few letters in the script. It slowly just go away and we don't even realize why they go. These are some of the questions out of this little investigation came in one's mind. Can we have correct and accurate number of segments for the letters decided? Do we have form-wise or action-wise grouping? Not the width-wise like in type design. Do we really need typeface, a separate typeface, only for viewing the letter for the kids and rendering a letter for the kids? Or are we going to use the same typeface which is meant for the books, which are for used for the novels, and which are from 100 years going on? This new technology can be an option, but not, of course, referring the old material again. Thanks a lot.